Okay, children, from worksheet 1, there few questions have been given in the first section. Add the following. Third bit, let us see here. The third bit is given here, 2 and 3 by 11 plus 9 by minus 11. 2 and 3 by 11 plus 9 by minus 11, it is given. Okay, fine. Let us write the question. First question, that is 2 and 3 by 11 plus half 9 by minus 11. What are the denominators here? They are not in standard form. So first one is mixed fraction. You have to write in improper fraction. How will you write 11 2s are 22, 22 plus 3, 25 by 11. Whereas the second one, so the denominator has negative symbol, negative sign. So you have to write the same negative sign to numerator, minus 9 by 11. Now they are in standard form. So since the denominators are equal, we can add the numerators. That means you can see here, they are like rational numbers. 11 is the denominator, 11 is the denominator. So what we can do directly, we can add the numerators, that is 25 plus of minus 9 upon 11. Understood na? 25 plus of minus 9 by 11. So here plus 25 minus 9. Yesterday in video I have told you, if one is positive, one is negative, what we should do? We should go for subtraction. 25 minus 9, 16. So here, what is the greater absolute value? 25. 25 symbol is plus. You will get plus 16 by 11. So this is the ultimate answer. Okay, you can write either 16 by 11 or you can write in mixed number. If you divide 16 by 11 in rough, I am doing in rough. So here you can observe. 16 by 11, if you express in mixed fraction, how you can write? 11, 16, you divide by 11, 11, 1 is 11. The remainder is 5. You can write as 195 by 11. Okay? 195 by 11. So what is the answer of the first one, the third section? Sorry, first section, third one. That is 2 and 3 by 11 plus of 9 by minus 11 equals to 16 by 11, or if you express in mixed fraction or mixed number, it can be expressed as 195 by 11. Now let us go for the fifth bit, children. That is given minus 2 and 5 by 6, minus 2 and 5 by 6, plus 13 by minus 6. So these also, let us write the mixed fraction as improper. Minus 6 2s are 12, 12 plus 5, 17. Minus 17 by 6. And plus half, 6 has negative symbol. So that's why we have to write positive 6, but this negative sign will go to 13. That means it will become minus 13 by 6. Okay. Whenever you write a standard form of any rational number, ensure that there should not be any negative sign for denominator. If negative sign is there, that you have to write to numerator. Now here we have got the equal denominators. We have got equal denominators. If denominators are equal, it is very easy to add. So we take the common denominator, that is 6. Now we can write directly, we can add minus 17 plus half minus 13. Both are negative. Yesterday I explained you. When both are negative, what we have to do? We have to add them. So if you add minus 17 and minus 13, you get minus 13. 17 and 13, if you add 30, since both are negative, minus. Minus 30 by 6. Minus 30 by 6 means then it is not in standard form, because 30 is divisible by 6. That's why what we have to do? We have to cancel. How to cancel this? 6 1s are, 6 5s are. Okay, that is, we get minus 5 by 1. Minus 5 by 1 means minus 5 only answer. Okay, and this is rough work. Whatever I have done, this is for third section. rough I am mentioning in cloud. So this is the process of adding the given rationals. Okay, so here the first section, you observe that, note that denominators are common. Denominators are same. So this is the common denominator problem. That's why we are adding directly. Yogesh, don't write anything. Don't annotate. Stop annotation, Yogesh. Is it clear to you? Okay. Now no more salutation, children. Just you focus on explanation. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Okay, now I unmuted you all. You can ask doubt. First one and second one, is it clear? Did you understand?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Thank you. Now you can copy these. Those whom sir did not do these in your classworks, now you can copy. I am giving you time. Okay, don't type any namaste or good afternoon. Now you focus on explanation only. You can salute, you can wish me only just before going to start the class. Once if the class started, you focus on explanation. After copying, let me know. Then I will go for next problem. See that your surroundings are noise free. No disturbance, children. Copy by that time I am copying the next question. Okay, -7/64 plus 3/-16. So you observe carefully, -7/64. Okay, it is in standard form. But whereas 3/-16, you have to write as -3/16. Okay, because in standard form, always the denominator must be positive. Okay, children, this can be done in two methods, either LCM method or cross multiplication method. So here I am going to explain you LCM method. So better to know LCM method. In LCM method, directly you can simplify three or more rational numbers at a time together. So what is the LCM of 64 and 16, children? The LCM of 64 and 16 is 64 itself. Why? Because 64 is a multiple of 16. Of the two numbers, if one number is multiple of second number, then the greater number itself is the LCM. So here you can write why I have taken 64 down, because 64 is the LCM of 69, 64. Okay. So I have got some queries in chat box. Okay, no. Now 64, you divide by 64. 64, 1 is 64. So what we have to do? This numerator -7 must be multiplied by the quotient, what you got by dividing 64/64. 64, 1 is 64 now. So I am multiplying numerator by 1. Plus, again here, what is the numerator? -3 into 64, you divide by 16. How many times it goes? 16, 4 is 64. That means into 4. So here we get -7, 1 is -7 plus half. -3, 4 is -12. Whole by upon 64. Have we got minus 7, 9, minus 12? Minus 7 into plus 1 is minus 7. Plus minus 3 into 4 is minus 12. Now both are negative. Yesterday video I have told you. What is that? When both are negative, you have to add them. But the sum will be negative. So that is minus 19 you get by adding minus 7, 9, minus 12. And the denominator 64 as usual. So now if you observe the numerator and denominator, they don't have common factors. That's why the answer itself is minus 19 by 64. Now you can copy, children. I am unmuting you. If it is clear, you can copy. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. I unmuted you. Now you can interact with me. Is it clear to all of you? Respond, children.
Sir.
Yeah,
yes,
very good.
Sir.
Okay,
yes,
now you
sir.
Can now you can
yes,
copy.
Sir.
Now you
yes,
can copy.
Sir. Sir, can you explain once again, sir?
Shall I explain once again? Okay. Now here, the second section, second problem, it is given that minus 7 by 64 plus 3 by minus 16. Is it given now? That you have to write in standard form. Minus 7 by 64 as it is, plus half, 3 by minus 16, how you have to write as? Minus 3 by 16 you have to write. As in standard form, the negative denominator should not be there. The denominator must be positive. After writing positive denominator, then you find the LCM of the two denominators. 64 and 16. What is the LCM of 64 and 16? 64 is the LCM. So now what do you have to do? Whatever the numerator is there, minus 7, must be multiplied by 1. Why? Because if you divide 64 by 64, what do you get? 1 you will get. Okay. Close the bracket. Plus half. Again, minus 3 into, you divide 64 by 16. How many times it goes? 16 1 is 16, 16 2 is 32, 16 3 is 48, 16 4s are 64. That means 4 times. So minus 3 into 4. So minus 7 into 1, minus 7, plus half, minus 3 into 4 is minus 12 upon 64. So here minus 7 plus minus 12, how much you will get? The sum of two negative integers is negative itself. So that is minus 12 plus 7 is 19. That is minus 19 by 64. Okay, now is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good. Now you can copy this.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes,
second.
Sir.
Okay,
yes,
okay.
Sir.
Okay, children, you can copy.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Now start responding. You can copy this. Let us see the third section. Second section, third problem. Third bit, let us see now. So here there is no sufficient place. Once again, I am writing this all here, side. So I'm writing the solution once again. So the LCM we got 64. So here minus 7, we are multiplying by 1. Why 1 means? Because 64 by 64 is 1. Plus half, minus 3, we have to multiply it by 16 4s of 4. That means we get minus 7 plus half minus 12. By 64. That is nothing but, don't annotate, children. Minus 19 by 64. Okay, so this is the answer. Mass. I will come to know who are annotating simply. So don't write anything on the screen. So here your name will be displayed. So that is not good, na? You have to be systematic. I cleared all the drawings. Let us see the third sectional, third bit also. What is the third bit? 5/8 plus half minus 3/5. You observe, children, the two rational numbers already they are in standard form. So directly you find the LCM of 8 and 5. What is the LCM of 8 and 5? Since there is no common factor, 8 5 is 40 is the LCM. Ensure that your surroundings are noise free. So 40 is the LCM. Now what you have to do? You have to multiply 5 first numerator by 8 5 is 40 na 5. This 5 is numerator. This 5 we have got the quotient. When we divide 40 by 8, we get the quotient 5. Now minus 3 into, you divide 40 by 5, how many times it goes? 5 8 is 40. So 8 times. Okay, now you simplify this. 5 5 is 25 plus minus 3 8 is -24. 25 plus half minus 24 upon 40. Okay. What is plus 25 minus 24? One is negative, one is positive. We have to do subtraction. So 25 and 24, the difference is 1. Since 25 greater, its sign is positive, you get plus 1 upon 40. 1 by 40 is the answer. Understood now? Once again, let me explain this. 8 and 5, they are denominators. So here we get the LCM of 8 and 5 is 40. Then now you write the numerator, first numerator, that is 5 into 8 5 is a 40 plus minus 3 into 5 8 is a 40. That equals to 5 5 is a 25 plus half minus 3 8 is a minus 24 upon 40. Plus 25 minus 24. One is negative, one is positive. We have to go for subtraction. What is the difference of 25 and 24? 1. Since the 25 is greater, 25 symbol is plus positive. We have to write plus 1 by 40. That is the final answer, children. Now, is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Now you start responding and copy the solution. Neatly you have to copy.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Avoid yes, sir.
Striking and overwriting.
Completed, sir.
Completed, huh?
Completed, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Completed, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay.
Yes, sir.
Completed, sir.
Okay, I will go to the next problem. Abu Ikram, what is your doubt? You send a message that you have doubt in last problem. Okay, this is previous slide. Where is your doubt? Tell me. Abu Ikram, unmute your audio and you can speak to me.
Sir, 5 by 12 plus minus 9 by 20.
Where it is? 5 by 12 plus minus 9 by 20.
Yes, sir.
So, which question it is?
Last question, sir.
Achha, in that section, last question, huh? Okay, I'll explain here.
Yes,
so, Shaikh Yasin, don't annotate. Your name is coming here. The same, it is recorded also. Okay, I'm going to explain. Okay, I'm going to explain. See, you are opening two devices, so you are getting resound children. That should not be done. So at a time you are opening, you are attending the class from two devices, same resound you will get. Okay. So as Abu Ikra asked me one doubt, I am going to explain. That is the last problem, 5 by 12 plus of minus 9 by 20. 5 by 12. 5 by 12 plus of minus 9 by 20. Sheikh Yasin, this is your work. You see the annotation, how it is disturbing. So it is recorded also. Now I am going to clear them. Okay, fine. What is the LCM of 12 and 20 children? Once again, you write the given rational numbers. 5 by 12 plus of minus 9 by 20. So the LCM is 12 and 20. What is the LCM of 12 and 20? You can go for rough work. So here you can work out to find the LCM. So by 2 you can divide. 2 6 are 12, 2 10 are. Again by 2. 2 3 are, 2 5 are. Now it is not divisible by 2, now by 3. 3 1 are, 5 is not divisible as it is. Now again by 5. 5 1 are, 5. Now what is the LCM here you will get? 2 into 2 into 3 into 5. 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5. So 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12, 12 5s are 60 is the LCM. So you have to write 60 as denominator. Then how to write this? First you have to write numerator 5 into how many times 60 is divisible by 12? 12 5s are 60 na? Again 5. Plus half. Minus 9 is the numerator into how many times 60 is divisible by 20? 3 times. 23 is a 60, na? So 3. Now we get 5 5 is a 25 plus half minus 9 into 3 minus 27. Because minus into plus minus 9 3 is a 27 upon 60. Now we get one is positive, one is negative. So you have to go for subtraction. So 25 and 27, the difference is 2. Since 27 is greater absolute value, the sign is negative. So it is minus 2, minus 2 by 60. Now it is not in standard form because 2 and 60, they have common factor 2. So if you cancel by 2, 2 ones are, 2 thirties are. Ultimate answer you will get minus 1 by 30. Minus 1 by 30 is the ultimate answer. So let me explain you one more time. 5 by 12 plus 9 minus 9 by 20. So what are the denominators here? 12 and 20. What is the denominator of, what is the LCM of 12 and 20? Here we have got, we have worked out here in rough place. We have got 60. Then you have to write 60 here. Now first numerator 5 into 12 5 is 60 na? That's why 5. Close the bracket, plus half, open the bracket. Again minus 9 into 23 is 60. Okay. Then you will get 5 5 is 25 plus minus 9 3 is minus 27 by 60. That is 25 plus half minus 27 is minus 2. Minus 2 by 60 means minus 1 by 30. Okay. So this is the solution. If you have doubt, you can ask me children now.
No, sir.
Is it clear to you? Okay. You
no,
can copy.
No, sir.
You can copy
yes,
this.
Sir.
No, sir. It is clear to us, sir.
Okay. Now you
yes,
can copy,
sir.
Children.
No, sir. It is clear, sir.
Yeah, no problem. You can copy now.
Okay, sir.
Yes, sir.
Copied, sir.
Okay.
Copied, sir. Copied also.
copied, sir.
Previous problems also copied, you copied, sir.
Copied, sir.
Copied, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Copied, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Sir, copied, okay, sir.
Now the third section, it is asked to verify x plus y equal to y plus x. This is called commutative property of addition. So let us verify the commutative property. What are the given numbers? X value 5/7, y value -3/2. First, LHS, left hand side, we have to find the value of left hand side. What is LHS? X plus y. That means, what is x value? You substitute in the place of x. 5/7 plus half y value -3/2. Now what is the LCM of 792? The LCM is 14. Because 792, they are co-prime numbers. They don't have common factors. So the LCM is the product itself. Now what do you have to do? First you write the numerator 5 into 7. How many times divide 14? 7, 2 times, 7, 2 is 14, 2, plus, again, numerator you write, -3, multiplied by 2, how many times divide 14, 7 times, 2, 7 is 14, so 7, yeah, that implies 5, 2 is 10, plus half, -3, 7 is, minus into plus, -3, 7 is
21,
by 14,
21.
Okay, that is 10 plus half -21. One is positive, one is negative.
Minus
what do you have to do? Yeah, minus 11.
10 minus 21.
So how to go for subtraction?
Minus 11 plus 14, sir.
Yeah, yes.
Minus
yes, yes, yes. Yes. Because one is positive. Yes, correct. So this is LHS value. Okay. Now let us find the RHS value also. Since there is no time, so let us erase this problem. Next problem, and this problem RHS is, what is RHS? Y plus X. What is Y value here? -3/2 plus X value 5/7. Now, what is the denominator? You get LCM 14 because 2 7 is 14. They are co-primes. Now, what do you have to do? -3 into 2 7 is 14, 7 plus
11.
Numerator 5 into 7 2 is 14.
14.
Yeah. So, -3 into 7, -21 plus 5 2 is 10 upon
10.
14. So again, -21 plus 11, how much will get? -11. -11/14.
-11/14.
Have you observed, children? Both are equal or not?
Yes, sir.
They are equal. Yes, sir. LHS
yes,
and RHS.
Yes, sir.
Now,
sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we can conclude that here LHS value, RHS value, both are same. Therefore, LHS equals to RHS. Hence, we can say that X plus Y is equal to Y plus X. That means the commutative property of addition of rational numbers is verified. Hence verified. Shashank brother, don't annotate the screen. Hence verified. So this is the solution, children. Now you can copy this.